Don't trust the cloud. You need to back up your email and online data. It's really no surprise that we rely on online services or the cloud more than ever these days. From email to photo sharing and even social media, an amazing amount of information is being shared and stored online. Sometimes it's only online, and that is a problem. Remember, if it's in only one place, it's not backed up. And no, the cloud services themselves are very unlikely to help, especially those free services. But Leo, I hear you saying, cloud services have backups. Sure, indeed they do. They should. It'd be a pretty poor service that doesn't. But here's the deep, dark secret. Those backups aren't for you. Those backups exist to protect the service from issues that they experience. They're almost certainly not there to act as a backup for you. If the service suffers some kind of catastrophic or heck, even minor problem, the idea is that they can restore their services from their backups. If you, on the other hand, accidentally delete a file or lose access to your account, those backups aren't going to help you at all. If you ask the service, they will politely tell you that you're out of luck. If you get an answer at all, that is. Backing up is your responsibility. I'll bet it's even called out in the terms of service, or more likely, the terms of service will say it's not our responsibility. You and I, we're on our own. So, how vulnerable are we? Well, to begin with, start with an inventory of just what it is you have online. Email, photos and videos, documents, music, anything you store primarily online is at risk. At risk of what? Well, account compromise and hacking. Even if you get your account back, everything in it could be deleted. Accidental deletion, both account and individual files or items. You and I, we've all said oops from time to time, haven't we? Service shutdown. This one is something I think a lot of people don't think about, but it happens. I've experienced it, and sometimes services can go away without any warning. And of course, provider technical failures. This could be anything from poor internal management to external events taking out data centers. Account lockouts. This one seems to happen most often when you're traveling, but it is possible to get locked out of your own account for many different reasons. So how vulnerable are you? Very. But Leo, I hate the cloud. I don't trust the cloud. I don't use the cloud. So none of this applies to me. What I find funny is that reaction often comes to me via email. You know, email that's run by online service providers in the cloud. Sorry to say, but as much as you think you're avoiding the cloud, you're still soaking in it. And if you're not backing up your email, you're at risk of everything that I just listed. Now, the solution for email is very simple. Download and install a desktop email program, configure it to access your email via IMAP, making sure it's downloading everything, and then ignore the desktop email program if you like. Just make sure it's running. It's downloading your email to your PC, which, of course, you're also backing up. Desktop email programs that you can use for this might include Thunderbird, generally my first recommendation. Microsoft Outlook, although be careful, use the classic version, the desktop version. This new Outlook thing, it doesn't count. It doesn't do what we need. Tools like EM Client or Apple Mail or many, many other desktop email programs. You might even use one online email service to act as a backup for another. And there are also some email-specific backup utilities and services that could be used. Now, what about the other cloud services? There are, of course, a bunch of other cloud services that you're using that provide a variety of features. In the Google ecosystem, besides Gmail, we've got Google Drive, Google Photos, YouTube, and so much more. On Microsoft's side, we've got Outlook.com, of course, but there's OneDrive and Office 365 and all sorts of other things. Apple has iCloud and Photos and iWork, photo and video sharing services. I have a bunch of pictures up in Flickr. Social media, a lot of people don't consider that a place where they store things, except when they can't find what it is they posted a month ago. And of course, things like your financial and medical records, even your password managers fall into this category. For all of these and more, I strongly recommend either of two backup methods depending on the service that you're using. First, never delete an uploaded original. Uploading a photo to social media? Keep the original somewhere on your PC where it'll get backed up. Uploading a video to YouTube? Again, keep that original somewhere local in case your YouTube account goes away. As long as you have the original, you can always recover from online loss. Periodically download. It's unfortunate that this isn't as easy to automate as it should be. But as an example, I simply have a reminder once a month to visit a few of the services I use and explicitly download or export the data that's been accumulating there. Once again, should that service disappear, it'll be an inconvenience, but not a disaster. One of my common recommendations is that you back up data that's kept encrypted in some non-encrypted form, and then secure that backup some other way. That could be physical, based on its location being secure or placing the backup copy in a safe. It could be technological, using a different encryption so as to reduce the chances of both encryption mechanisms failing at the same time. If the backups are kept online, then make sure their storage is kept appropriately secure. But the concept is simple. Your backups of sensitive data are themselves sensitive data. Treat them that way. Test your backups. A backup that fails when you need it is just as good as not having a backup at all. My recommendation is that you test any newly created backup scheme soon-ish after creating it, and then periodically thereafter. At home, that might mean once a year. In a business, perhaps you might want it to be more often. Understand also that data migration can be messy, lossy. By that I mean if you take data from one service, contacts say from one email provider, for example, and you attempt to import them to another provider, you might find that not all of the fields or information made the transition. You'll still have whatever's in that original export, of course, but getting the missing pieces into the new destination could take additional effort. Contacts are my most common example, but it can apply to just about anything. Do you know where your backups even are? It's oh so tempting to set it and forget it, with too much emphasis on the forgetting part. This is particularly crucial for businesses, as the person who set it might not be the person who needs it sometime down the road. That means, of course, documenting what you've done so you can find what you need when you need it. And yeah, I have a couple of simple lists in my note-taking system. Honestly, that's all it takes. Bottom line, even if you're using the cloud, perhaps especially if you're using the cloud, backing up is your responsibility. There will always be trade-offs between convenience and protection, but the first time you face a disaster, you'll have a very quick and perhaps brutal assessment of whether or not you did enough and whether it was all worth it. When deciding how much to do, well, I leave you with this. It's usually better to have backed up a little too much than not enough. Now, go back up your email. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/179744. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.